हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? सो हियर नमन जहांगीर वेलकम्स यू टू द चैनल डीप टॉक्स। एंड लेट मी रिमाइंड यू वन थिंग दैट इफ़ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल देन प्लीज़ डू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड एन्जॉय द वीडियो। सो हियर आवर टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज़ ब्रिक्स, दैट इज़ BRICS। सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टूडे आर वट इज़ ब्रिक्स, वट इज़ द मोटो ऑफ द ब्रिक्स, एंड हाउ डज दिस रेलिवेंट टू इंडिया, हाउ इंडिया गेट्स बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दिस। एंड आई थिंक यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट न्यू डेवलपमेंट बैंक दैट इज़ रिसेंटली इस्टेब्लिश्ड बाई ब्रिक्स। सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दैट ऑल्सो। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग मच टाइम, लेट्स गेट स्टार्ट। सो हियर एज वी कैन सी दैट ब्रिक्स नेम इज़ फॉर्म फ्रॉम द इनिशियल लेटर ऑफ दीज फाइव कंट्रीज, एंड दीज कंट्रीज आर ब्राज़ील, रशिया, इंडिया, चाइना एंड साउथ अफ्रीका। ओके, लेट मी टेल यू दैट दीज कंट्रीज आर द ग्रुप ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, दे आर स्टिल डेवलपिंग, नॉट डेवलप। सो वी कैन ओवरऑल से दैट ब्रिक्स इज़ द एक्रोनिम फॉर एन एसोसिएशन ऑफ फाइव मेजर अमर्जिंग नेशनल इकोनॉमीज विच आर ब्राज़ील, रशिया, इंडिया, चाइना एंड साउथ अफ्रीका। लेट मी टेल यू वन मोर थिंग दैट इनिशली साउथ अफ्रीका वॉज नॉट द पार्ट ऑफ दीज फाइव कंट्रीज, दैट्स वाई इट वॉज ओनली टर्म्ड एज ब्रिक, नॉट ब्रिक्स। एज सुन एज साउथ अफ्रीका बिकेम द पार्ट ऑफ दीज फाइव कंट्रीज, इट वॉज टर्म्ड एज ब्रिक्स। एंड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन 2011 समिट, प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ द साउथ अफ्रीका अटेंडेड इट्स वेरी फर्स्ट समिट इन चाइना। ओके, एंड सेकेंड पॉइंट इज दैट दीज ऑल फाइव मेम्बर्स आर ऑल्सो द मेम्बर ऑफ G20 countries and G20 members. Now if we coming to the history of the BRICS, who formed BRICS, then in 2001 for the very first time, Jim O'Neill, who is the British economist who coined the acronym BRIC in his publication Building Better Global Economic BRICS. Actually he is the chairman of the Goldman Sachs Asset Management. Actually, Goldman Sachs Asset Management is the multinational financial company that engages in the global investment banking and other financial service. So this was all about the history of the BRICS, that who coined the BRICS. But if we come to the point that why these five BRICS countries are important to us, so in order to make it more clear, let me share you some figure and facts. Okay. Let me tell you that 43% of the total world's population lives in these five countries, and these five countries have the 30% of the total world's GDP. It means that if we combine it in dollar, then it has the combined GDP of over $16 trillion. Okay, and one more point, then half of the world's foreign exchange and gold reserves belongs to these five countries. So as you can see here that there is so much to develop, so there is so much to work in these countries. Now I think it's very clear to us that why these five countries need BRICS, because they can help each other in order to promote economic growth, trade promotion. They can promote mutual trade and investment so that they can create a business friendly environment for investor. In this way they can become developed countries from developing countries. Let's talk about the meeting of the these BRICS. Actually, for the first time, foreign ministry of the initial four BRICS states met in the New York in September 2006 at the margin of the general debate of the UN General Assembly. Let me clear you again that it was BRICS state, not BRICS, because since 2006 South Africa was not there. Okay, and since 2009 BRICS nation have met annually, so they decided to met annually from 2009, and a full-scale diplomatic meeting was held in Yekaterinburg, Russia on June 16, 2009. So as I told you that from 2009 BRICS nation have met annually. So very first summit on 16 June 2009 in Yekaterinburg of Russia, and the host leader was Dmitry Medvedev. Okay, now coming on the second summit, then second summit held on 15 April 2010 in Brasilia of Brazil, and host leader was Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva. Okay, now coming to the third summit, then third summit held on 14th April 2011 in Sanya of China, and the host leader was Hu Jintao. Coming to the fourth summit, then it was held on 29th March 2012. Okay, and host country was India, in Delhi of India. Okay, and the host leader was Manmohan Singh. Coming to the fifth summit, then it held on 26th to 27th March of 2013 in Durban of South Africa. Okay, and the host leader was Jacob Zuma. Okay, coming to the sixth summit, then it held on 14th to 16th July 2014 in Fortaleza of Brazil. And the host leader was Dilma Rousseff. Okay. Now coming to the 7th summit, then it held on 8 to 9 July 2015 in Ufa of Russia. And the host leader was Vladimir Putin. Okay. Coming to the 8th summit, then it held on 15 to 16th October 2016. Host country was India, Benavilum of Goa. Okay, and the host leader was Narendra Modi. Okay, and if we talk about the 9th summit, then it is going to happen in China. Okay, and the host leader will be Xi Jinping on 3 to 5 September of 2017. Let's talk about the main outcome of the summit. Let me tell you that we are only considering main outcome, not every issue of summit. So New Development Bank is the official name of BRIC Bank, okay, and which is established by BRICS nation. So this treaty signed in July 2014 at the very 6th BRICS summit, which held in Fortaleza of Brazil. Now this treaty came into force in 7th BRICS summit, which held in Ufa of Russia in 2015. Now headquarters of New Development Bank is situated in Shanghai, China, and its present president is K.V. Kamath, which belongs to India. Let me tell you that president is appointed on rotational basis, okay. So its initial authorized capital is $100 billion. Why do BRICS need New Development Bank? So come to the first point. First point is very clear to us, that for funding infrastructure projects in developing countries. But why I mention this second point, that all five members have equal voting rights? Let's come to the Bretton Woods organization in order to get that. Okay, so according to this Bretton Woods organization, voting power is determined by capital share, like in IMF and World Bank. Let me tell you that in IMF and World Bank, these two banks is dominated by rich countries, as they are having high capital investment, and as they are having high capital investment, their voting share also increases. Let me clear you that more the capital investment, more they have voting share. Okay, in this way they are dominating the small country. So countries like USA and Japan have dominance over IMF and World Bank, okay, because they have high investment and they have high voting share. So the only reason to introduce New Development Bank, so that New Development Bank can substitute IMF or World Bank, so that no country can dominate over the other country, okay, and all countries having equal voting rights. Although all these five members have equal voting rights, but let me tell you that China have also high capital investment in New Development Bank, okay, or somewhere China is also dominating New Development Bank. As we can see that recently India took a loan from ADB, that is Asian Development Bank, for its development. Why not from New Development Bank? Because somewhere China is also dominating over New Development Bank. So friends, this was all about ब्रिक्स एंड प्लीज़ डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल। थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग। जय हिंद।